What is up, guys? How are you all doing? And welcome back to another video. Last week, I did ask you guys to give me some questions based on the 2022-23 season. So that's what I'll be doing today. I will be answering all of your questions. So if you do enjoy this video, make sure to give the video a big thumbs up and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. So yes, as you could tell by the start of the video, I haven't put the intro yet. At the moment, the reason I've done that is because I want to introduce you guys to the new intro and outro of the 2022-23 season. So here is the intro. So yes, that is the new intro for the upcoming season. Now, let's get into the thing that you guys have clicked on the video for, the Q&A. Starting with question number one, do I think that Michael Flynn is a good idea? Now, this is a question I can't answer for now because the season's literally just ended. It ended literally a week ago, so I'm not going to be able to answer that at the moment because yeah, I'm not sure what his style of plays, Michael Flynn's style of play is going to be like, the type of plays he's going to be looking for. So yeah, I'm going to probably, it's probably going to be something that we'll be able to answer after like 10 games into the season, something like that. Or maybe when the season starts, when we make a few signings. So yeah, for now, I can't answer that. But what I did hear from what he was saying at halftime in our 2-1 win against Crawley, he did have a lot of ambitions for the club. So yeah. At the moment, it does sound like a good idea, so yeah, it's a pretty tough one for now. Now we're on to question number two. If Ben Garner didn't leave, do I think we would have been title challengers for the season? Now, this is another hard one because this season's been full of very big, tough teams like Bradford, Leyton, Orient, Stevenage, Northampton, Carlisle. There's many of them, so yeah, the fact that we finished 10th, we had three different managers during that period as well, so I reckon we would have made the playoffs. I don't think we would have been title challengers, but I do think we would have made the playoffs if we did have Ben Garner. So we're now on to question number three. This is another tough question to ask. The question is, if I could take three players back from last season, so the 21-22 season, who would it be? First of all, Harry McCurdy. I'd take him back easily. The second one, I'm going to go for a midfielder, an attacker, and a defender. So the attacker, Gonfire and McCurdy, the midfielder, I'd probably say Jack Payne. Defender, I'm not sure. I'd probably say Manny Egbo. It was probably one of my favourite defenders, or Akin Odemeyo. I don't know, it's a tough one. Either Akin Odemeyo or Manny Egbo. I'm going to go for Manny Egbo. So Harry McCurdy, Jack Payne and Manny Egbo. So we're now on to question number four. Where do I think Sol Brim will be in his prime? Now, obviously, he's had an amazing season. He's shown that he's got great potential for the future. If Middlesbrough do get promoted to the Premier League, I reckon in his prime, I reckon around mid-table Premier League, top of the Championship level. So, yeah, I do still think he'll be all right. But yeah, my answer, I'd say mid-table Premier League. So we're now on to question number five. Do I think that Gavin Gunnin should have been manager instead of Jody Morris? Now, I was really surprised that Jody Morris did leave this early. I thought if he wanted to leave at earliest, I thought he would be like the transfer window coming up. So yeah, Gavin Gunnin, at the time before he did stop being a manager because of Jody Morris, he had two games. He beat Grimsby 5-0 and then drew 3-all against who was it, Gillingham. You guys might not be happy with my answer, but I do think we should have Gunnin as a manager instead of Jody Morris. Yes, you can't judge someone off of two games, but yeah, he's already had three games as manager this season, and he's not lost yet. He's won two games and drew one. So yeah, my answer, I would have been happy with who is it, Gavin Gunnin instead of Jody Morris. Now we're on to question number six. How do I feel about this season? Now, earlier in the season, I did predict us to finish second. Obviously, that went down the drain. We finished 10th. But, yeah. Compared to what most of the fans' expectations were, compared to how we finished, I'm not really happy with it. So my opinion on the season is not been good. So now we're on to question number 7. What's my best starting 11 based on my opinion? Goalkeeper, Solbrin. Don't need to argue with that one. Left back, Fraser Blake Tracy. Centre backs, I'm going to go for Tom Brewitt. And I'm going to go Tom Clayton. Right back, another easy one, Romeo Hutton. Centre mids, I'm going to go for... This is a hard one. I'm going to go McEachran. He's been decent this season. Jake Kane. And Johnny Williams. Yes, I know you guys will be commenting. Johnny Williams has had a few games as left wing and right wing. But I agree. But his main position is centre mid. So that's why I'm going for Johnny Williams as centre mid. Left wing, I am going for Jacob Wakelin. He has so much good potential for the future centre. Hopefully, he does stay for long enough at Swindon. Striker, Charlie Austin. Right winger, I'm going to get Romeo Hutton. He didn't have that much of a good start. At the start of the season, it was more coming to the end of the season where he did start bagging in a few goals. But Ben Murphy, he is going right wing. So obviously people are going to have mixed opinions for that question. So if you think differently to what I said as the 11 best players, comment down below. We're now on to question 8. Jack Coughlin or Connor Brann? Now, we obviously signed Jack Coughlin through our academy. Connor Brann, we signed him at the very start of the season. Can't remember where from. But I've only seen Jack Coughlin play once. I haven't seen Connor Brann play yet. So I'm going to say potential-wise, yeah, I'm going to go for Jack Coughlin for that one. So now we're on to question number 9. Who should we sign for next season? I'm going to go for two Walsall players here because obviously Michael Flynn, at his time of being a manager, he has managed Walsall. So I'm going to go for two players. Manny Mumph as a defender because I do think we need to improve in our defence. And if Charlie Austin goes, I'm going to go for Danny Johnson. If I am right, I think he is the top scorer for Walsall as well. So yeah, it would be ideal if he does come. So we're now on to question number 10. What has been my favourite game that I've been to this season? Now, there's loads of options, but there's one game that stands out for me, and that is Swindon Town versus Grimsby when we did win 5-0. So, yeah, because Charlie Austin's first goal on his debut, Saidu Khan's first goal, it was goals galore, and I'm going to go for Swindon versus Grimsby when we did win 5-0. Question number 11. Who has been the most underrated player this season, based on my opinion? You guys might disagree on this one, but I'm going to say Reece Devine. I think he's only played like 2 games this season because of injury. This season's not been as good as what he wanted. But he played against Leyton Orient, top of the league. He is absolutely class that game. So yeah, hopefully the injuries does stop next season. And hopefully he can do really well. That's if he stays though. My most underrated player, I'm going to go Reece Devine. Now on to another very controversial question. Do I think the sacking of Jody Morris was a good idea? My opinion, straight away, I do agree. I do think the sacking of Jody Morris was a good idea. And if we are aiming like in a few years' time to get out of this league and maintain a spot in League One. With Jody Morris, I don't think we were going to do that. His experience, the style of play wasn't going to match Swindon at all. And it weren't going to get us out of League Two. So, yeah, my opinion, it was a good idea to get rid of him. Yes, he hasn't had a transfer window to get his own players yet. However, it was pretty obvious that he wasn't going to do as well as Swindon. Only getting like two wins in 1 point in like 12 games or something like that. So, yeah, wasn't looking good for him at all. So, yeah, my opinion, it is a good idea we did sack him. We're now on to the 12th and final question of the video. What has been my favourite away day this season? Now, unfortunately, I was only able to go to one away game this season, which was Swindon versus Walsall when we did lose 2-0 in the Carabao Cup. So I'm going to just pick like the best away game that I haven't been to this season. So I'm probably going to go for either Swindon versus Mansfield when we won 5-2 or Swindon versus Wimbledon when we did win 5-1. It's a very close one, but I'm going to go for Swindon versus Mansfield there. So guys, those were all the questions that I am going to be able to answer in the video. I'm sorry if I wasn't able to answer your question, but yeah, that is the end of another video. If you did enjoy this one, make sure to give the video a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel and put on the notification bell if you want to be the very first person to watch when I upload a new video. So like I said a week or two back, I will be covering the news that we do get from Swindon in the pre-season. So the next video I do will be about that. So yeah, see you in the next one. Not to do. Chill.